fifth grade class that we had in the morning. Thank you. Now, if you all would please stand, and fifth graders, turn and face the flag. Let us do our pledge of allegiance to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. Fifth grade, have a seat, and then you want to take your caps off. Next, I'd like to introduce our faculty and staff that are with us this evening. I'd like to introduce first the fifth grade teachers that have worked very hard and diligently with this class all year. Mr. Tom Baldwin and Mr. Bob Snyder. We also have some other staff here that I'd like to introduce. I introduce Debbie Patterson, our art teacher, PE teacher, and all-around helper. Ms. Stephanie Keel, second grade teacher. I think she has several of these students here. Our third grade teacher, Ms. Kayla Mansfield. Our kindergarten teacher, Ms. Diana Nicholson. And she has a few of these kiddos here also. Ms. Thomas, Ms. Jessica Thomas, our first grade teacher. Ms. Sonia Davidson, our preschool director. And also Mrs. Beth Harden. I'm sorry. And she also had many of these students in her class. At this time, we're going to have the fifth graders come up here and sing their song. We have a song called I Am Jesus' Little Lamb. If you want to look and follow the words, it's in the hymnal, the maroon colored book, the Lutheran service book in the pew, and it's hymn 740. So, fifth grade, you can leave your caps down under the chair. And please come up here.
Ever glad that God
This past year, we had at our theme, for our school theme, for putting on the full armor of God. How many of you have been able to see some of our virtual videos that we've had on the YouTube and things like that? We've been kind of going through those verses. And fifth grade has helped me with that. And fifth grade has also helped me with several things. But we have, I want to read to you the verse here for Ephesians 6, verse 10. And this is really a good verse for them as they go on to this next step in their educational adventure as they go on to do their work in middle school. St. Paul writes, "Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of the dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything to stand, stand firm then with your belt of truth buckled around your waist, with a breastplate of righteousness in place, with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions, with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints." So, keep praying, right? Next year will be different than this year. So I'd like to talk to you just a little bit. My message to you guys. I call this One More Chat with Mr. K. And I've had several chats with several of these fine young students in my office. Won't say who, not gonna say what. I'll keep that between us and them. But they are kind of showing themselves by ducking down low. But we won't notice that. I've had all these students in my office, though. They've been helping me the last quarter or so since we had Lutheran Schools Week. They've been doing announcements for me or with me in the office as we do in the morning with our morning announcements. And they've done a fabulous job. Even the shy ones, of which I won't mention either. We had a few that we had to really kind of convince they could do it, and then after they did it, they saw they could do it. And that was wonderful to see that growth also. And I really enjoyed seeing them grow throughout the whole year. But I also want you to understand that things are going to be different as you go forward. Life is all about change. And if you've lived some life, you know. And sometimes it hits you in ways that you weren't even expecting. And I pray and hope that we've prepared you in some manner or form here at St. John's. Mr. B, Mr. Snyder, but also Ms. Keel, Ms. Nicholson, Ms. Thomas, all the other teachers you've had here at St. John's. That you are ready to take on the challenges that are coming for you. Because as you get older, I'm sorry to tell you this, but as you get older, people expect a little bit more out of you. You can't be playing all the time. I know, boys. I know. It's tough. But you can do it. And I see some maturity also, even when I see the silliness. We were just talking kids right now, right? 10-year-old kids, fifth graders. But yet, there have been some really amazing things that I've seen them do and say. House project they just finished up with. I don't know if some of you got a chance to see some of those. The floor plans that they worked with these house projects, working with volume and dimensions and things like that, cutting and snipping and putting together. They really did an amazing job. I think we have some architects in this group. I hope you've had fun this year. I hope you've had memories this year. And you probably are going to be a little anxious as you go forward next year, right? What do you think, Brady? Will you be anxious next year? I don't know. Sometimes it's maybe good to be ignorant of what the unknown as you go forward, right? But unfortunately, sometimes you need to prepare for the unknown, and you got to get ready for that. So we hope that we prepared you and got you ready to be taking on this challenge that is going to be coming on come August, right? It is with a very unfortunate heart that we could not have sixth grade this coming year. And I know there have been many that have said, I wish you could have sixth grade. It just wasn't possible this year coming forward. But the Lord's will be done. I've accepted that. And we go forward and try to help these guys get ready as best they could for the next step. And it's coming. So anyway, I'm not going to take a long time here. I just want to say I wish you all the best. I've really enjoyed getting to know all of you in all your special ways and your special personalities and your special likes and dislikes. And even with some of the drama that I've had to put up with in the office with some folks. But that's okay. I hope that you've grown from that. And I think we have improved from that. So that's good. That's good. So anyway, I wish you luck. I wish you God's blessings. And I wish you all the best. And I pray that you'll come back and visit and maybe tell me a little bit about how you've been doing. Because I'm really anxious to know how you've been doing. And I'm losing some really good helpers too with some things that we go around here in the school that help me with the cones and the hand truck and things around doing stuff. And tomorrow I'm going to use some fifth graders of you that will be here tomorrow. I do need to have some chairs moved, so I'll probably have you guys working for me a little bit tomorrow too. All right. So I say, whatever you do, do all to the name of Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God his Father in all that you do. Amen. Okay, so the Bible verse that we have for this class is a little different than the theme we had. It comes from Jeremiah, and God giving a promise to his people then, but we are his people too, in faith through Jesus Christ. And God says, I know the plans I have for you. Maybe you don't know your plans going forward, but God knows your plans. And God has prepared you and made you in a special way that he can use you in the kingdom. So God says, I have plans to prosper you and not to harm you, and plans to give you hope and a future. Your future is bright, and I hope that you will understand that. All right, so at this time, I'd like to have Mr. Snyder and Mr. Baldwin come forward. I'd like to present some of our awards for the fifth graders. Let's see, let me get a hand mic so you guys can be heard well. Testing.
Yep.
There you go. So we're going to be going through the presentation of the awards in the full of the.
Okay, so these are the Christian Character Awards. One second. Wrong folder.
Okay, yes, that's good. Put that on the bottom. There you go. And you can put that one. Put that one last too. Okay.
Okay, so the following awards are the Christian character trait for each student. So Natalie Baca Belmonte, your character trait is determination. Okay, and in second, Lorenzo Cubides Cardona, wisdom. Okay, Jenna Daniels, orderliness. Eris Espinosa, diligence. Okay, Lily Garland, friendliness. Hey, Olivia Goble, who's new to St. John's this year, so courage. Raven Henry, fairness.
Fairness, yeah.
If it wasn't fair, he would let me know.
We had similar discussions about fairness, yes, that was good.
Bentley Malone, contentment. Levi May, virtue. Mason Norman, discernment. Madison Peak, who spent much of the year in a knee brace, optimism. Lily Shannon, gentleness. Okay, the next is for our AB honor roll students. These are the fifth graders who maintained A's and B's throughout the year, all quarters. They are Lorenzo Ubides Cardona,
Don't leave the stage too quick.
Jenna Daniels. And Eris Espinosa.
Please give them all a big round of applause. We have one more award that is given to us by the Daughters of the American Revolution, DAR. I don't know if you're familiar with them or not, but they are very much an advocate for education and for academics and for leadership and for example and virtue. And so we have present the award for the Daughters of American Revolution Certificate of Citizenship to Eris Espinosa. Congratulations. There you go. You put that all in that folder right there. You get a folder. Okay. Thank you. You may be seated. Very good. So this year at St. John's, we've gone through a lot. I kind of enlisted up there for you to see. This year at St. John's, of course, we had to deal with the COVID-19 and all the cleaning and hand washing and all the extra protocols we required for our school to stay safe and stay face-to-face instruction. We socially distanced, we walked down the hallway, we kept ourselves separated, especially in August, September, October, November, and December, when everything was very, very tight and we had to stick very strictly to the protocols. Mr. Baldwin was our homeroom teacher and religion teacher all throughout the year. Mr. Snyder, he taught the core subjects. They used the old first grade room with Mr. Snyder because it had the interactive board and the display board, although we didn't get another camera, video, data camera in the other fifth grade room. But they had also already gotten used to their routine in that room, so they stayed there pretty much, they stayed there the rest of the year, going back and forth. We had a different kind of drop-off in the morning as they sat in the chairs in the cafeteria, and you can kind of see how some of the chairs are set up in there. And pick up in the afternoon, we also use those chairs. We had a Lutheran school week in March, and that was a fun week. We had science, and we had sports, and we had pajamas, and all sorts of stuff. We did a lot of fun that week in March. Mad Science Day was really a very special day, and a lot of children really got into the different science experiments we did and had a lot of fun with that. We are virtual chapels this year. We only had one service in the church here, and that was this week. We had all of our classrooms this past week distanced by a pew in the church sanctuary here. But all otherwise, the rest of the year, we've been working with our chapels with the virtual chapel and on our YouTube channel. So, and they're going to stay there. So these fifth graders, they can always go back and see the videos that they made, the fun that they had, but also proclaim the message of Jesus Christ and his love for us. We ate lunches in our classrooms. The cafeteria was closed. Not sure how that's going to modify for next year, but we will do that. And there were many times people would come in my office to chat. I had a lot of phone calls. Mr. K, can I make a call? Can I call my grandpa? Can I call my mom? Can I call my dad? Not going to mention any names, but the parents know what phone calls they got during the day. Or grandparents. Where's Mr. Tim? Yes, he got a few. There were other things, too, that they come into my office for, and they borrowed my tape this past year for this past couple of months to make their projects and things like that, so I was willing to share that. And I always try to give them a little bit of advice in trying to go forward and give them success in their work. But we had to go through a lot this year, and really a lot of memories that we had, and I think that they'll remember this year for all of the different things that we did and the fun that we had. But especially the new folks that we have, I do want to recognize those that we had for just this year. Olivia Goble, would you please stand? Braden Henry, would you please stand? Eris Espinoza, would you please stand? And Madison Peake, would you please stand? These four children came to us, some of them, after we started the year, and they were they acclimated very well to the classroom, and I think they had a very good year. Thank you. You may sit down. Then we've had some that have been here since preschool. Preschool, right? Lorenzo, would you stand up? You've been here. Let's see. Anybody here has been here longer than Lorenzo? No? Oh, Lily Shannon. Lily, stand up. Yes, that's right. Lily. Lily has been here since preschool. Huh? Jenna, please stand. Yes, she's been here since preschool. So they're really going to have a big change from leaving the place that they've been doing their most of their learning. Let's see. Mason, when did you come here in second grade? So Mason was in second grade. Levi, when did you come here?
Kindergarten.
Okay. Bentley, when did you start?
Kindergarten.
So you and Levi started then. When did you start, Natalie? Kindergarten. So the four of them starting kindergarten, okay, very good. So we have quite an arrangement here of some of these buddies, and if you notice some of the picture roll that I had rolling up here, and I'm gonna try to send that out to you all so you can have a recording of some of the pictures I received. I received a ton of pictures from a lot of folks, especially the ones that have been around here a while. They had a lot of pictures from all different years, so it was really fun to go through those and see how they've developed over the years since kindergarten and such. Okay, well, I think it's time we present to them the certificate of celebration for accomplishing their elementary education tonight. So if I could have the staff please come over here and line up for a congratulatory greeting to them. Mr. Schneider, I would like you to read off the diplomas, and I will give them to them as they come. Oh, you see this one? Right. Go ahead.
Okay, Natalie Bacabelmonte.
So here's yours.
Lorenzo Cubides Cardona.
Lorenzo.
Jenna Daniel. Eris Espinosa.
Congratulations.
Lily Garland.
Congratulations. You want to look here? Look the same way it has been hiding your mouth. There you go. Now shake Mr. Snyder's hand. Thank you.
Olivia Goble.
Congratulations. You want to face your heart? Yeah. Okay. Congratulations.
Braden Henry.
Congratulations. Very good. Well done. You want to take a bow to your mom? That is definitely his personality.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Bentley Malone.
Well, Mr. Malone, congratulations. You want to turn and face your family too and say hey?
Levi May. Mason Norman.
Congratulations. Face back there to see mom. There you go. There she is. Yeah, I can see her.
I can barely see her.
All right, good. Congratulations, Mr. Snyder, for getting through.
Madison Peak.
Congratulations. Madison is my grad student. I had her mom, Melanie, back a few years ago. Yeah, it's been a few, right, Melanie? Yeah. Back in second grade here in St. John's. So Madison, it was really special to have her there here with me this year.
Lily Shannon.
And then those that you baptized, a baby infant. Thank you, Mr. Snyder. Thank you, staff. You may be seated. Let us stand for praying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Pastor Clocker wishes he could have been here, but he had had a scheduled vacation with his daughter and her birthday celebration planned way back. So he is very disappointed he was not here to be with the students and be able to congratulate them and to wish them all the best too. But I am here in his stead, and I want to give a blessing to all of these wonderful students here that have completed their elementary education and getting ready for that middle school educational experience. So now may the Lord bless and keep you, and he make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you, each one of you. May he look upon you with his peace and guide you with his love. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. So this time we'll have the students
Do the staff go first or the students go first? Students, okay, students, if you'd please go put your hats back on. These hats, Ms. Patterson and Ms. Espinoza worked with them. We thank her for offering these hats. Even though they're not graduating high school or college or any kind of large degree like that, we still think it's kind of cool that they have the hats there to show the accomplishments that they have made this year and in their elementary education. So let's give them one more round of applause. Let me get some music playing. Unless Mr. Dot, Ms. Dot, can you start the music for me? Do you see the link?
Rico was born in 2014.
Okay, well, there's an advertisement for us.
Age of 3.
Cleaning up our messes,
and always smiling. Especially Levi, Billy says. I have great memories with Mr. Ed, Mr. B, Miss Lanham, Miss Shane, Miss B, Miss Bane, Miss Bryant, Miss Thomas, Miss Hill, Miss Gilzo, Miss Martin, and Mr. Snyder, and Mr. K, and Miss Manning. I will always and forever remember this school where these people raised me, and I will always think of this special place that I have childhood. I will truly miss this school.
Everybody! Oh. Got this, Ben. Got this. We need you too, Dana. We need you too.
It's so hard to leave. It is. Because it's
ways that we've had with the interaction and stuff like that. So I really appreciate everything you've done, Nancy. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm going to miss you next year, but I've got you on speed dial, so you can always give me some help and understanding how things come on. Thank you. PTO president, any parents out there that are back to be back next year?
Is my grandpa. Testing 1, 2. Okay. All right, now you can talk there.
We had to put up with that class.
Yeah, that was kind of the worst.
It, well, I know.
You would talk and you would go. We each three of us have a card for Mr. K, Mr.
Two.
Baldwin, and Mr. Snyder.
Two.
Well, you already gave yours to Mr. Snyder.
Yes.
So, I guess we're all gonna say something. So, Mr. B, I just want to say that you have been one of my favorite teachers because we would watch.
I thought I was.
You let me be my friend. Thank you.
Yeah, that was the best.
Oh yeah, and go dumpster diving.
Oh yes.
And Mr. Baldwin, I loved your class because all we did was copy notes, and
yeah, it didn't take much effort.
But we would have to do these little tests, which extra credit was really fun, and we got to watch a lot of movies, which was also like the bomb. So
we watched
Remember the Titans. We watched Passion of the Christ. Well, we watched Passion of the Christ. Parts of Passion of the Christ. And we watched The Lion King for Pajama Day. Hit that. The Butterfly Circus. So, Mr. B, thank you for everything.
Oh, yeah, and
Bentley.
principals we've had here. You've been fun, nice.
Wow.
What was that supposed to mean?
Understanding, right?
Yes, an understanding.
Yeah, understanding.
And thank you for whenever we can just substitute you for them.
And calling
us
that million times
in the office.
And
get on the phone
and
call, right?
Candy! And Mr. K giving us candy, and he just let us play whatever we want.
A million times!
We got a free play computer lab, and he's just been one of the best principals ever.
Wow. I would like to ask you
a question.
Go ahead, Janice.
First of all, Mr. Snyder has been a really great teacher. Very, very bad, but we won't shut up. I can't blame him for that. We won't shut up. And locked you out of the room. That was hilarious. Walking across the forbidden area. I talk about it.
I know.
So overall, he's just been a really great and fun teacher. Really great at teaching math. Really great at it. He's just a really good teacher. Also, I would like to ask a question for our class.
Oh God.
How come we talk all the time, and yet all y'all scared to just come up and like talk in front of a whole bunch of people?
And Mr. Snyder, I want to say that we've all acted like that you've been the worst teacher in the world, but you really have been one of our favorites, and I'm really going to miss you next year. Oh yeah, and he called us nose miners and nose minettes.
And when Natalie
and talkettes and talkers.
Yeah, that happened.
Hey,
not my fault.
Okay, so I do pretend like I really don't like them, but I actually do love all these kids. So the truth is out. I really do love you. I hope the Lord will bless you all next year and guide you. So
I want to say something. I just want to thank my mom and dad for letting me come here and meeting all these wonderful friends of mine. And I just want to thank everyone that came here for the graduation. And I just want to say thank you, everyone, for being friends.
Everyone that's helped me be a better person at this school, I want to thank Mr. Snyder, Mr. B, and Mr. K.
And get your name out of me.
Punched me in the back about 5 times.
What are you talking about? I don't repeat it. What do you mean?
Let him go.
And I will miss all of you.
Come on, Natalie, say a word. Give him a good morning, Mr.
President. I'm hungry.
Me too.
Well, where do I begin? I just want to thank all the teachers that have taught me of these past years and all the great principals. And I want to also thank God for helping me and giving me the strength to learn. And I can't forget my parents, because my parents have played a big role in how I've learned.
I'm new at this school, and I've never been here before. And let me tell you, my first day was pretty crazy. Because I didn't know anybody.
I don't even remember it.
But I just want to thank the teachers and all my friends for being nice to me. And except for some people who bit me. And for everyone helping me learn new things, Mr. Snyder and Mr. B, and for everyone being welcoming, even though I haven't been here for as long as some other people have, that I still get to be part of our fifth grade class. So, thank you.
Thanks somebody for all the refreshments. Somebody thank all the people for all the refreshments.
Unicorn, start talking.
Be quiet. I want to thank everyone who brought the refreshments, and all the food laid out, and
I just want to say a few words to you all. As I was thinking about this, it is pretty amazing that we have so many people who have been around here for such a long time. And for some of the students here, I've had the privilege, and so have some of these other teachers, of teaching their older brothers and sisters, of teaching their cousins, of teaching their mom. And so it's been sort of a generational kind of thing for some of us. And for those students, I'm talking to you, those of you who have been here since kindergarten and pre-kindergarten around that time, you made your way to my heart a long time ago. And for you guys that just got here, you have certainly made your way into my heart these last 179 days. And it's been a real privilege to be here with all of you.
And when I was younger, Mr. B, this was my favorite thing, because when we would come to pick up my older sister and my older brother, while we were waiting, I would stand at the front at the little diamond, and Mr. B would pitch to me, and I would hit, like I acted like I would hit a home run. And that was the best memories I've ever had.
Yeah. All right, there's still some food on the tables. Let's go ahead and finish it up. And thank you all again for coming out this evening for this wonderful celebration for our fifth graders. And have a safe trip home and get some rest, fifth graders. Enjoy your summer. Enjoy your time away. So come back and visit at your feet. Thank you.